The standard was the best I think I've seen from this competition, I thought.
This is the first time I've been here, and for me, I thought it was one of the great strengths about the competition is it's very, I was saying to my colleagues before, it's very egalitarian, so everybody gets something, everybody gets
they
something.
They all deserve to be there.
Which is fantastic.
I think very even, too, across all five singers. I think it was very competitive, and the discussion was quite, you know...
Made it difficult.
Made it
really,
very difficult choosing ultimately a winner.
The fact that it's a real sort of smorgasbord, you've got one of each, kind of, which was fantastic. And with them all of, in their own way, of roughly the same kind of level.
Yes.
All incredibly talented, all with great futures, I think probably, but trying to choose which particular one.
It was
a wonderful night, wasn't it?
It actually came down to things that aren't often discussed in this competition. Such as accuracy and, you know, ability to work with the orchestra and things like that, and how they managed in that situation. And that usually, in a competition just based on potential, we don't get to that stage.
That's right.
Well, often with a competition, you get one Rolls Royce and five Datsuns, you know. And
I had a Datsun.
Well, there you go.
It was very fast.
Souped up one.
I'm not knocking Datsuns.
I think there were five fantastic voices, but each one of them needs work.
Yeah. Absolutely.
And the wonderful thing about this competition is that it gives everybody an opportunity to develop from their levels, and that's it's wonderful.
And
it's
I love this little theatre. It's gorgeous.
Oh, yes.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah. Beautiful acoustic.
Lovely hall.
And this is a competition for young singers.
It is,
And it provides them a chance between sort of finishing, you know, university or conservatory or whatever, and the next step. And that's the important thing, the hardest step in the business, I think. You know, so it's good.
Yeah. What brought Maximilian to the fore?
It's a very unusual voice, so it's not often you get a countertenor.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way that...
but a good one.
Yes, and stands out.
Yeah.
So it's a vocal colour also that stands out.
It's a beautiful voice, it's not a hooty countertenor.
And he's very musical. Mm. Like his ornaments, I loved his ornaments.
Yes.
And I actually said bravo.
At 23, he's already accomplished. He's already... quite
and sophisticated.
Yeah, sophisticated.
He worked very well with the orchestra, and he was intelligent, and it was very felt, very sincere performance.
Yeah, very close to the text for me, I felt.
Actually, that was one of the very special things all night, was how into their roles I felt all the singers were.
Yes, very committed.
They were really selling their, like, you know, the... committing suicide, you thought he was about to take the jump, you know.
Yes.
And all
Jeremy
of that.
Was
so it was very impressive, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Well, look, the top of the list, we expect very good voices. That's the first thing. Good voices and good singing. So they've really got to make sure their techniques, they're on top of what they're doing, and they're trying to consolidate their techniques so that will liberate them to be able to interpret what they want and communicate with the audience. But we also, as Conal pointed out, we want to hear really good text, intention and understanding in what they're doing, and communication. So their languages are really quite good tonight.
They're doing really well.
Their musicianship they have to learn the music accurately.
They've got to be really well prepared for a competition like this.
Yeah. Mm. And choose repertoire wisely for their voice and for their performing personality, for what they're ready to do at this stage.
I think one of the difficulties with this competition is that each piece has to be a winning piece.
Yeah.
Each piece has to be able to stand on its own.
That's
because
they
have a stack of repertoire that they've got to learn, and there's no telling what the judges are going to ask for and what combinations. So each piece has to be something that really does deliver what the listener wants to hear.
Mm.
Linnhe has done an amazing job, I think, in...
fantastic.
No, you really have. In bringing together such a really, really good crop of young singers.
Oh, thank you. Yep.
Semi-finalists as well. They were really strong. Yep.
Yeah. And how fabulous to have the Australian Opera Ballet Orchestra.
Oh, yes.
To you know, for all of them.
Yeah.
Probably some of them, it's the first time they've sung with orchestra, I'd imagine.
Yeah. I think so.
And, you know, that's one of the best up there.
That's class.
If I've got to put in that bit about how marvellous Dr. Handa is.
Oh, you should.
For providing that orchestra.
Absolutely.
Because for any young opera singer, for any old opera singer, having an orchestra under you is absolutely
can be lumpy.
Tops.
And they were all really involved. You could see them all smiling and enjoying
every
singer up there.
And such a supportive conductor too, Johannes Fritzsch is terrific.
Isn't he?
He's so great with young singers.
Just fantastic, yeah.
Come on a bigger batch next year.
Yes.